We know Dick Turpin wrote to York, we learned that at college, but just what happens on the way may not be general knowledge. He must have stopped, of course, if only to greet his horse. But where did he stop and what did he do? Listen for a while and I'll tell you. When Turpin rode to York, first he stopped at Highgate. He knew his ride would fail unless he looked after Bonnie Black's best. So he went in the old king's head, where the barmaid had a talk. His flashing eyes gave her a thrill. She fell for him of her own free will. So he pinched her cheek, then he pinched her till, and on he went to York. Giddy up, Bonnie Black's best. Only a few more miles, I guess. Gallopy, gallopy, gallop you must, and don't even see your tail for dust. When Turpin rode to York, next he stopped at Barnet. He just had half an hour to spare, so he went into Barnet Fair. At a coconut he tried, but only hit the store. So to the rifle range he went. The gun he used was somewhat bent, and he shot the fat girl in her tent. And he went on to York. When Turpin rode to York, next he stopped at Baldock. Poor Black Bess had cast the shoe. Dick stood wondering what to do. There was no blacksmith in sight, so he began to walk. Turpin said, well, here's defeat. But old Black Bess said, it's all right. I can still go on in my stocking feet. So on they went to York.
Giddy up, Bonnie Black Bess. Only a few more miles, I guess. Gallop, 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 you must. Don't let it be your tail for dust.
When Turpin rode to York, next he stopped at Stamford. He boasted of his liberty. The knight was barley, so was he. The price set on his head made all the country talk. The cashier said, "Odd bodikin," and made a grab at Dick Turpin. But the mayor lashed out and the man cashed in, and on they went to York. When Turpin rode to York, next he stopped at Rutland. A most uncanny sound they heard. Poor old Bess was most perturbed. Her knees they shook with fright. Her face was white and chalk. Said Dick, that noise is weird, and so towards the woodland he did go. Then a voice said, "Stop your nonsense, yo!" So on they went to York. Giddy up, Bonnie Black Bess. Only a few more miles, I guess. Gallopy, gallopy, gallop you must, and don't let him see your tail for dust. When Turpin rode to York, next he stopped at Grantham. The face coach he held up that night. Really he was most polite. He only asked for food, or preference pickle more. A maiden said, "My life at stake. Whatever you ask for you can take." So he cut himself a slice of cake. Then on he went to York. When Turpin rode to York, next he stopped at Selby. He jumped the turnpike with a leap and woke a hedgehog from its sleep. Although the night was dark, he could see just like a hawk. "There's a red light far ahead, I guess. We'll catch it up." "Not me," said Bess, "but the real light of the Scotch Express." So on they went to York. When Turpin rode to York, last he stopped at Fulford. Bess could scarcely crawl, it's true, and Dick felt like Dick Turpin too. Just 2 more miles to go, so Bess tried hard to walk. Her height was 6 feet yesterday, but she worn so much of a length away. She looked like a dashing, so they say, when they arrived at York. Never mind, Bonnie Black Bess. We've got to York at last, I guess. So now sit down and have a good rest. For we've got to get back to London in the morning.